You're watching UNICEF television. In New York, an important new agreement will have far-reaching consequences for African children. Schools for Africa is a highly successful partnership between UNICEF, the Nelson Mandela Foundation, and the Hamburg Society.
I'm amazed that we are today 26 countries fundraising, and that we could today sign the phase two to incorporate 5 further countries into Schools for Africa, and that close to 1 million pupils can now go to school.
Schools for Africa has raised $50 million 1 year ahead of target and is now expanding its program from 6 to 11 countries. The second phase of the initiative, launched in New York, will promote even more child-friendly schools, with a special emphasis on education for girls and vulnerable children.
It is clear to me that the results that we are looking for in education for children in Africa go far beyond the ability of any individual ministry of education or government or agency to single-handedly achieve. And so what is significant about today's initiative is that we are pulling together all the key stakeholders and partners in a collaborative effort.
Success has brought tremendous gains to African school children, but it has not obscured the urgent need that remains.
Mr. Mandela extended his personal endorsement to the Schools for Africa campaign in 2004. And as much as we acknowledge the contribution that Mr. Mandela has made, I think starting in South Africa, but indeed the world, the point is that he is now 91. And he has asked us to find new hands to lift the burdens. I think that the Schools for Africa campaign is very specifically an initiative that picks up the burden of education.
UNICEF and its partners believe the Schools for Africa program will eventually grow beyond primary schooling to allow African children at every level to realize their right to a quality education. This is Chris Niles reporting for UNICEF Television. Unite for Children.